Selling IIoT for OEMs, take zero. All right, so this is actually, this question here is a very common question that I get from hardware and software manufacturers, okay? OEMs, original equipment manufacturers. You know, what is an OEM? For the people who watch our channel who know what OEMs are, but there are also people who don't. So an OEM is a person who makes a turnkey piece of equipment or a turnkey piece of software, okay? So it is a product, they make turnkey products that are RTD, ready to deploy for end users. So an example of an OEM would be a company called Comexi. They're in a Spanish printing press manufacturer. So they sell you the printing press, big, huge, multi-million dollar press. You install it in your facility. They send out a technician, they run it off. And that machine, that original equipment manufacturer, has given you one turnkey piece of equipment that handles a single operation inside your business, okay? Most plants have lots and lots of machines, and each of those machines were built by an original equipment manufacturer, okay? We also have software OEMs. It's not equipment manufacturers, but we have software OEMs who develop turnkey solutions like ERP systems, MES systems, and SCADA systems. What we wanna do is we wanna talk about what is the value proposition for OEMs and why should they adopt Industry 4.0 principles when they build their equipment. The answer to that's actually pretty simple. Number one, the cost is low. An OEM is gonna ship a piece of equipment IIoT ready. All we care about in the community is that OEMs are using hardware and software that supports IIoT protocols. Things like DMP3, MQTT, et cetera, et cetera, LWM2M, et cetera. The cost is low. I mean, if I'm an OEM and I'm selecting a PLC manufacturer to handle the automation for my piece of equipment that I'm going to sell to lots of different people, I have a choice. I can choose to use PLCs that don't support IIoT protocols. And we care about, when we talk about IIoT ready, we also mean open architecture. That is, just because you're using MQTT doesn't mean that you're open. Just because you support the MQTT protocol doesn't mean you're open. If I write my own custom payload right here in my MQTT, in my MQTT transmission, when I'm publishing my topic payload, if I create my own custom payload, that means that my broker's got to be able to decipher the way that this data is structured, then that's not open. That would be proprietary, okay? So this is a perfect example of, you know, Siemens and Allen Bradley, they're not the only two. Many manufacturers have their own custom protocols that the client and the server speak the same language, but they are not common languages in the open space. What we care is that OEMs are shipping equipment IIoT ready using open architecture, okay? The value proposition, number one, is the cost is low. If I choose a PLC that is IIoT ready, it doesn't cost me any more than if I pick a PLC that isn't IIoT ready, okay? It doesn't support IIoT. So for example, we had Siemens in the office here earlier this week, and we pitched to Siemens, who is a OEM hardware manufacturer, and we pitched to Siemens the value of IIoT. They are further down the road than Allen Bradley and Rockwell Automation is. Siemens is supporting open IIoT protocols like MQTT. They have an MQTT function block that you can drop into an S7 1200, 1500, and it publishes open. We just found that out this week. We just got an example of it. One of our engineers downloaded that function block. We're testing it over there on our test bench right now. Not SparkPlug B, but open MQTT. We call that, I like to call it flat MQTT. So they do Siemens PLCs starting with the S7 1200 line, which starts at like $400 and goes all the way up to the big dogs, up through the 1500, up to the big dogs, supports open architecture. They also have a edge of network PC that is similar to the Opto 22 Groove Epic, which we got a chance to see this week as well, Siemens provides, which is an edge PC, PLC, HMI all rolled into one, and it runs Windows 10 IoT all in one unit. And we're gonna have one of those in our office and we're gonna test them here in another month or so. Anyway, I wanna get back to the value proposition for OEMs. We were making the value proposition to Siemens this week as to why they should support IIoT, they should ship their equipment IIoT ready. So number one, the answer is the cost is low. Number two, it's high value, but it's value add, right? You don't have to have IIoT be the core of your platform. You need to support IIoT so that your hardware or your solution can scale with your customer's business, right? That's number two. And number three, you get to ship it with the IIoT ready sticker. That just looks pretty. So you're gonna be able to ship your equipment with the IIoT ready sticker on it, okay? And what that means is that all of the engaging cutting edge engineers, developers, purchasing agents, directors of technology for the end users who are looking for IIoT and don't really understand what it is, they get to see your sticker and know that you're part of the ecosystem, you're not against the ecosystem. You're gonna be able to order these IIoT ready stickers from 4.0 Solutions.